So, Micah, do you want to give us a little bit of a sense about what open source is?
Sure. Well, open source, to me, in practical terms, basically means that refers to software that's been released under open source licenses. And what open source licenses have in common with all licenses is that they grant certain intellectual property rights to users who are subject to the license. Usually, in this case, they're copyright rights. So they're rights to reproduce, to use, and to create derivative works, which means, you know, for example, borrowing someone's source code and writing your own program, integrating it, or in some cases, just borrowing someone's library of compiled code and making function calls to it. So that's kind of how you sign an open source license. And they're generally free for anyone to sign, and the source code is generally provided for free or in a manner that is free in the sense of unrestricted to users who are willing to be subject to the terms of the license. And they have to be if they use it, generally. Now, they range from, these licenses range from more restrictive licenses that impose more requirements on the user, generally requirements aim to guarantee that the source code the user produces will in turn be available to other people. And an example of that is the GPL license. On the other extreme, which I think would be represented best by the MIT license, they could put very little restriction on the user's use of the computer program that they produce, or the restrictions that they in turn can impose on it. Now, there's two things that are important, I think, as a sort of a knock-on effect of these licenses. Number one are the legal consequences, and the other one is the practical consequences. The practical consequences are that a lot of the material that is released under these licenses is going to be freely available to anyone who wants to look at it. It's disclosed, which means it's in the public domain, basically. And people will often ask me, how can you patent something in blockchain if it's in the public domain? And they will also ask me, how can you patent something in blockchain if it was given to you under a license, or if it was produced under a license, but say a given implementation, that is designed to prevent people from patenting things or restricting access? To answer the second question first, if you're not a party to the license, if you didn't sign it, then the license won't affect you at all, generally speaking, because it generally sounds in copyright, which protects the particular form in which an idea was practiced, as opposed to the idea itself. This is sometimes referred to as the merger doctrine in copyright law. So if you learn all about a given blockchain implementation and then go out and write your own based on what you've learned, generally speaking, you're pretty safe under copyright law and you're not subject to the terms of its license. The second side to that is some of these licenses are not very restrictive, so they simply won't prevent you from, for example, filing patents. Almost none of them prevent you from filing patents, even the GPL, and many of them won't prevent you from enforcing the patents. And as for the other one, almost any invention that is subject to a patent is basically some kind of an incremental improvement to what has come before, a combination of previously existing elements or a slight improvement to a previous invention. So generally speaking, an invention that's a slight improvement over something in the public domain can often be subject to patent protection, you know, depending on whether you get a patent.
Thanks for that. Really, I wasn't expecting that long of an answer.
Oh, sorry.
Really impressive. No, I appreciate it. That was really impressive.